The Bible says that God created the earth in opposites. But the contradictory paradigms he did not know of were environment and development. Contradictions created by man, the new self-styled God of Earth.
Ranked as a nation which breathes the highest level of polluted air. The country has been ranked at 125th spot in terms of tackling pollution. Over the last few years, India's performance in terms of controlling air and
has been struggling to deal with water is of smog.
The other studies conducted by several environmental bodies like
human progress, as a matter of fact, the whole of human survival depends on the smooth running of two processes together, development and environment. The moment one sees them as opposing each other, one invites one's own doom and destruction.
Several campaigns to protect the environment
disguise themselves as attempts to save the earth, whereas the purpose is narrower,
shallower,
and that of saving our own skin.
The earth will survive regardless of humanity being there or perishing. The present generation needs to wake up to the needs of seeing development and environment as being necessarily complementing and supplementing each other, rather than being contradictory to each other. Growth for the sake of growth is a symptom of cancer. And we all know, cancer kills. So does unsustainable growth and development. Sustainable development cannot be made to happen by a magic wand. It needs planning and execution, both of which are prerequisite for a balanced outcome. The attack on environment in the name of development will lead to a humanless graveyard that will be alien to the requirement of development. Development cannot afford to be blind. It has to keep pace with the environment.
There are certain things which humanity is simply too young to understand, such as the mysteries of life and death, or the mysteries of various forms of life on Earth. In its immature and impatient, self-centered and self-serving obsessions, human beings often forget that they are being suicidal. When destruction comes crashing in the form of tsunamis and earthquakes, cloudbursts and floods, then we blame Mother Nature and her mood swings. We conveniently erase our role of provoking her. The same will not go on for too long.
There is a limit to which all things can be used, misused, and abused. That limit is not far off between us and the environment. The greatest of problems staring at us today are man-made. Poverty, population explosion, hunger, and without doubt, pollution. How can we develop if we do away with our greatest ally, our savior, nature itself? A legitimate question is where to begin the change. Just celebrating the Earth Hour for an hour a year might be a great symbolic gesture, but sadly, it falls way short of the change in mentality that we need. The mindset of our generation needs an overhaul so that they can see and perhaps in time stop the destruction towards which our civilization is blindly headed.
You remember that home movie of the Earth spinning in space? One of those spacecraft continuing on out into the universe, when it got 4 billion miles out in space, Carl Sagan said, "Let's take another picture of the Earth. You see that pale blue dot? That's us. Everything that has ever happened in all of human history has happened on that pixel. All the triumphs and all the tragedies, all the wars, all the famines, all the major advances. It's our only home." And that is what is at stake. Our ability to live on planet Earth, to have a future as a civilization. I believe this is a moral issue. It is your time to seize this issue. It is our time to rise again to secure our future.
I consider this life.